to look at any book to call your friend. So if you have to read kinetic theory from a book, you are yet to know it. Does that make sense? If you have to read it from a book, you are yet to know it. And that's why I decided that you come up with your own definition. Okay? You come up with your own definition. The one that will be easier for you to understand. Okay? Using alternative words. Using words that mean the same thing as the key words in the definition. That way, you're very comfortable learning that one. So I'm going to pass your vocabulary sheets back to you, and that's what we use to practice and learn how to state kinetic theory. Can you read the book definition of the theory? The book definition. Where is yours?
I don't have it on this one. I'll give you another one.
You two, you don't have yours. Okay, Mendeville, read the book definition of the kinetic theory. The book one. All matter consists of tiny particles that are in constant motion. These particles are?
Motion.
These particles. What are the particles?
Kinetic energy.
Atoms and molecules. Mendeville, read your own definition. Read your own definition. All matter consists of?
Consisting.
Okay. Farrier, read your own definition.
All matter is made out of a small particle that does not change.
Okay. All matter is made up of small particles that do not change movement. Does that make sense? She has written it in a way she will understand it and it will be easier for her. Okay, Thomas, let's hear your own definition.
All matters are made of a small particle that in continuous movement. These particles are acting on motion.
Okay, all matter is made up of small particles that are in continuous movement. And these particles are atoms and molecules. Najma, let's hear your own definition. Okay. All matter is made up of very small particles that are in non-stop movement. So let's look up here. You see, when you know the meaning of words, you're able to do what? You're able to come up with your own definition that you'll be comfortable with. Okay? And now that you have your own definitions that you are comfortable with, you are going to learn it. Yes. You're going to learn it and present to me. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
That way, we would have achieved our first objective. What's the objective?
I can
state the kinetic theory. Does it say I can read from my book?
No.
Yes.
What does it say? I can state the kinetic theory. Okay? So what I'm going to do, I'll show you the little video of the particles of the gas. And that helps you to understand the definition. Okay? Can you all look up here? So these are the particles. These are what? These are what? The particles. How do you describe the movement? How do you describe the movement?
Gas, kinetic energy.
Okay? Moving what?
Non-stop.
The particles are moving non-stop. Okay? Happening too fast. And what's the word you can use to describe that? What's the word? One word for it?
Rapid.
Rapid. Let's look at this. What's this word?
Random.
What does it mean? Not planned. So now, looking at this, you begin to understand how the particles move. And what does motion mean? Motion means what?
Movement.
Movement. So I don't see why we should not be able to state kinetic theory. Okay? So now we're going to, as usual, learn in our tables. Remember, if any member of your table doesn't know it, your table is here to know it. Okay? If any member of your table doesn't know it, it means your table is here to do what? Yet to know it. Does that make sense? So we'll interact amongst ourselves at our tables. Okay? The beauty of it is that the definitions you have are the same. You know why they're the same? Because you all got your vocabulary from the same source. Whichever one you use, the others will understand it. Okay? Consist?
Yeah.
Made up of. Constant. You can use non-stop. You can use continuous. Okay? Motion means what?
Movement.
Insignificant. What does insignificant mean?
Not
important.
Not important.
Not important.
You are not important.
Too small to be considered. It's too small that you don't have to consider it. Okay?
Yeah.
What does sphere mean?
Round,
solid figure. How do you describe the shape of the particles? Round, solid figures. And that's why the particles are also spheres. What did we say collide means? Hit with force when moving. You know how you guys come in after your fire drill? How do you come into the building?
Pushing everybody.
Pushing everybody. With force. So when you do that, you're doing what? You're colliding. Okay? Collide. And what does definite mean? Clearly stated or decided. Okay? So now we're going to learn our kinetic theory. We are not going to read. We are going to learn it to enable us to be able to do what? State it. Okay? So I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Is it too small?
Yeah.
Insignificant.
It's insignificant. I love that. Okay? Haley says it's insignificant. It's too small. Okay. So, do I give you 10 minutes? 10 minutes? Okay. So, let's go. Let's go. Okay? Remember, if any member of your table doesn't know it, what happens?
Yes, all of them.
Where is yours?
Who doesn't have the worksheet?
Table doesn't know it all because he doesn't know it yet. You gotta help him.
He told me that he knows.
Practice it. Practice it together. Recite it for Carlos.
So write your own definition. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. What's another word for consist? Look at the vocabulary. What does consist mean? What does it mean?
Consist does not change consist. Consist.
Okay. Those are the likely words that you can change. You can use the alternative words, you can use the synonyms. Does that make sense? Thank you.
Continuous motion. Okay? So the words I've underlined are the ones you can think of alternatives.
Okay.
Particles, okay? called what? That's why they're called what? Spirit, okay? Sentient? Are the particles moving or not? Are the particles moving? So how do you describe, one word to describe how the particles are moving? One word. Constant. Okay? Constant. Carlos? Another word to describe how the particles are moving. She says constant. That the movement is constant. Okay? Constant, continuous, same thing. Okay? Rotor. Another word. She said constant and he said continuous. One word to describe the movement of the particles. Rapid. Okay? Rapid, the particles' movement is very rapid. Okay? Thomas? One word to describe the particles' movement. Okay? They're colliding. Okay? The particles are colliding as they move. Fourier. One word to describe the movement of the particles. Random. Okay? Random. The movement of the particles is what? Not planned. The movement of the particles is what? Not planned. So all these descriptions you have given, all the descriptions you've given about the movement of the particles will be what we are going to study in our second objective. All the descriptions you've given about the movement of the particles are what we're going to study in our second objective. So let's look at the second objective. I can describe the three assumptions of the kinetic theory in relation to gases. Okay? I want you to note from here. Okay? So let's go from here to here. I can describe the three assumptions of the kinetic theory. Everybody. What does assumption mean? What does assumption mean? Okay, take it as what the whole theory is all about. Okay? What the theory is what? All about. Okay? So those are the three assumptions we're going to look at. And you already have it in your notebook. So what I want you to do now is look at your notebook where you have the three assumptions of kinetic theory. Look at your notebook where you have them. Everybody. Look at your notebook. Notebook. Into your vocabulary sheet. Here. Write the assumptions in your vocabulary sheet. Write the assumptions in your vocabulary sheet.
Gracias. They're supposed to have all those in here.
Mm-hmm.
It's easier for them to learn it if they have it in a template than in their notebook. Just in their notebook.
Solo en la luna pasa con gente. Because I was doing that and then she said just one. Why? We had to copy all of those? I was copying those like in the middle of the day. But she said just to get energy. Look, everybody has the same thing. Trust me, miss. Trust me. I know what I'm doing.
You're trying. You're trying.
I've been dead this time. Okay. Jesus Maria.
Why? Assumption. You have to have assumption. She said, okay. Yeah.
Which one?
Assumption.
It's just only three. Because you should know the three of them.
Wait, so you say that we are going to like memorize this, right?
Commit it to memory. Learn it. You already saw it.
Yeah.
You were able to describe the movement of the particles.
But, so this word is the one that is going to be in the
Mm-hmm.
Then definition.
Then one, two, three will be here. One, two, three. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
You see how to spell it right.
Okay.
que no era antes Benique.
Should he be doing it like them? Because they have sentences or something?
No, like, they're like, my question was, like you told me to look up the ascension word over here, but then she looked for the definition, and then I seen, like, she wanted me to do is put my own definition back here. But what they're doing is, like, copying the same, like, the same way there is in the language.
Even if it's copy first the way it is in the notebook, okay? Copy the way it is in the notebook first, here. Does that make sense? Then your own. But I want you to copy the way it is in the notebook first. Then I will guide you, do you understand, into coming up with your own definition. Okay? Copy the way it is in the notebook first. Then we will look at the words you'll struggle with. But you'll be surprised that the way it is in your notebook, you know the meaning of most of the words. Like things like small, insignificant. What does insignificant mean?
Just insignificant.
What does it mean?
Like not really important.
Not important. So you see, you already know the meaning. Okay? What does rapid mean?
Like
happening too fast. Okay? Constant, you know the meaning. Random, you know the meaning. Okay? So as you progress, you'll be using the words. Now that you know the meaning of the words, do you understand? You can retain the book definition. Does that make sense?
learn two today. Then tomorrow we'll learn the third one. Does that make sense? Okay. So no excuses again.
Thank you.
have barely 1 minute left. The connected theory states that.
Do you want to present to the class?
No.
Okay, so do your exit ticket.